wanted to ask you guys, do you guys have anything that you all learned the hard way?
For me, finding a house was a very difficult challenge actually, because I have a very Muslim sounding name also, and moving to Bombay, searching for houses, I'd be like, I'll call up a broker and they'll ask, what's your name? As soon as I say my name is Arshad, they're like, oh, Muslim, it's very difficult to find a house
really
for Muslims.
They said that?
Yeah. Directly. Point blank, directly.
Damn.
Then I did have to end up finding a Muslim broker who then had contacts of people who would give houses to Muslims. I was too naive when I moved, but I was like, I'll move to Bombay. In the first 3 days, I'll be able to find a house. I'll move in. And I just took a hotel room for 3 days. And I was going around trying to find a house. And I couldn't find anything because they just kept rejecting me based on my name.
Yeah.
And then I ended up taking a PG and I stayed there for like a month or two. And that it took me 2 months basically to find a house.
That must have been so hard to have, you know, like your religion as a category for not getting a house.
Yeah, just looking at the name, nothing else. They didn't ask any other details, just the name and immediate rejection. While searching for a house also, I had to do this jugaad thingy, I'd say, because I had to tell people that my name was Harshad and not Arshad, because finding a house was difficult. So the problem was with the society that we were living in and not my flatmate. So my flatmate was okay with me being, I mean, why wouldn't he be okay with me being a Muslim? But he was okay with me being a Muslim. He was like, but for the building, let's just say your name is Harshad and not Arshad. And for the first couple of months, my name was Harshad. Slowly, like my building got like Muslim watchmen and all, and things got chiller, and then my name was Arshad suddenly.
Yeah, but this is a good point. You know, privilege also plays a huge role in your whole moving out process. Like, people can reject you for a house based on your caste or even like your sexuality and also your food preferences. Mm-hmm. Like, I have been not given a house because I'm non-vegetarian.
Education is such a privilege.
Yeah.
And because I lived in a hostel, started working from the hostel, so we had like a good little bit of a time to look for a house. We found a house that was in our budget, wasn't that great. We got a 1 BHK. So my friend was living in the hall and I was living in the room.
Yeah.
No, but we turned both into like a bedroom situation. I have had the luck of never requiring a broker. Like, in fact, the first time when we were looking for a house, right, from the hostel, we thought the broker is necessary.
Yeah.
And I found this house on OLX.
What?
Yes, there was a listing of a house in OLX, and I was
and
like,
and you trusted it?
I mean, we'd still check it out.
Yeah.
So I said, okay, let's go to this. So my flatmate was already had like an experience of living on rent here and there. I never had the experience of living on rent. And I found that house. That was like, wow, such a victory for me.
I would have not trusted it. A house on OLX just sounds sus. Since we had just touched on the topic of the struggles we had while we were moving to a new house, I have another fun game segment for y'all, which is called What Would You Do? So I'm going to give you guys scenarios and you have to tell me what would you do in that situation, okay? Your flatmate has their partner over almost every day. You eventually become friends with them and all of you hang out once in a while. A couple of weeks later, you start noticing that your grocery expenses have increased, and on digging deep, you find out that the roommate and their partner have been contributing in the expenses as one unit while consuming the food for two people. What would you do?
Is this from my life story? Hello? I never spoke this out. Wait.
This is actually very common. I've also gone through
okay,
this.
Okay, no. But I will have to say exact situation. But then this flatmate brings his girlfriend and stays for a thoda sa extended amount of time. But she stays in her own lane. She introduced herself to me. Definitely ate our groceries for some time. But I was like, okay with it. Such a nice girl. Kitna hi kha legi. So I had that kind of a hospitality for some time. But my flatmate was kind enough to say that, to offer that ki abhi se let's like split it for three people instead of two people. So like, just listen to me right now. Put it in your head. If I'm bringing a guest for an extended period of time, it's my responsibility to actually like say, ki, let's split this three-way instead of two-way.
I am generally a non-confrontational person, but if you are in a situation where you are not earning as much and you will need the groceries to be covered, then obviously I will have to go and ask, because otherwise if you are cutting down on money, spending money over here, then you will have to cut down on spending money somewhere else. So it is an ideal situation. I'll have to go and confront them, obviously. Yeah.
That's the ideal thing to do, but that's not what all three of us would do. Okay, next one. You live in a really nice society and love socializing. However, your watchman refuses to allow people from entering and leaving the society between 10 p.m. to 6 a.m. What would you do?
I'd move out.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, what is the point of living in a... But I mean, I'm also talking from a place of privilege, I guess. But what is the point of living in a house where you wouldn't be able to do things that you would want to do? So if there are too many restrictions, then I'd prefer not living in that house.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
What is this house? My parents' house?
Yeah, exactly.
In my hometown, where like it's 6 p.m., I'm like, what? You are tense that I'll get killed at 6 p.m.
Somewhere, this is also like a issue that a lot of women deal with. Like, it is a little different, the whole experience of moving out from a female perspective. And it has happened where my broker is like, nahi, ladke allowed nahi hai. And, you know, you have to come home at like 10 o'clock. We're sorry, but this is what the landlord wants. And yeah, they think that girls bring in trouble.
There was one instance where it's not the problem with the watchman, but the society uncles. I don't know why they feel that they are the gatekeepers of the society, I guess. And they spotted on the CCTV camera that there were a couple of girl friends who had come over like later in the night at around 11:30, 12. Immediate next day, they messaged my flatmate saying, why are so many girls coming to your house later in the night? And my flatmate was like, what is happening? And then finally, they spoke it out and all. But yeah, I mean, why do uncles think that it's their right to come and confront
moral
people?
Moral policing, yeah. Keep it to yourself. But yeah, I think
it's not a watchman issue, but a society issue, I feel, yeah. Sometimes.
Next one is, you move into a new apartment which has been freshly painted. When you go out of town for 2 weeks and you come home, you see that there is fungus on all of the walls and the room is smelling damp due to leakage caused by rainwater. Your landlord refuses to get this fixed as you are in charge of maintaining the apartment since you're the person who lives there. What would you do?
Try justifying, I guess, as to why they'll have to take the payment. But if they still keep refusing, maybe I'll just act passive-aggressively and send lesser rent if I have to end up fixing it.
Cutting it from the rent. Yeah, they cut our deposit all the time. We cut rent. It's a cycle.
I honestly don't know. I have not faced this issue yet. Because I have picked houses which are little new. Because I have made peace with living thoda away.
Yeah.
So you'll always see me living in Goregaon, Malad. Yeah. Like after Andheri, I've only lived that side. So I found thoda new constructions. Matlab fungus shuru hua nahi ki I'm out of the house.
With that, I would say you can find our podcast on Spotify, Apple Podcast, or any other streaming platform that you get your podcast from. And don't forget to give us a nice rating and review.